So let's think about the maximum number of iterations that we might have. What graph is going to give us the most iterations? And that graph is going to be this awful looking linear chain. How many iterations is that going to have? Well, it's going to have on the order of v iterations because we're going to have v vertices here. And how much work are we going to do in each one of those iterations? Well, each one of these iterations, we know that we will visit all e edges. So if we take the amount of work here as a product between v and e, we know that our final answer is going to be on the order of v times e. So we know that it's at least going to be on the order of v, and we know that it's at least going to be on the order of e. Probably, in any reasonable graph, there's going to be more edges than vertices. Otherwise, it's not a very interesting graph. And if that's the case, we know that the overall work complexity is going to be at least order of v squared. It's quadratic in the number of vertices, and that's bad. That is a very bad property. And so I told you at the beginning of the discussion here that this was a crummy algorithm, and this is why. We really do not want an algorithm that is quadratic in the number of vertices.